Talking with the Experts.
Hello and welcome to Talking with the Experts. My name is Rose Davidson from rosedavidson.com, and today my guest is Diana. And I'm not quite sure how to pronounce her name, so perhaps you could help me with that a little bit later. Anyway, Diana comes from Sweden, and her topic today is all things intentional, about intentional goal setting and mindset and digital strategies. Welcome, Diana, and how are you today?
Thank you so much, Rose, for having me on this conversation. Yes, you said it right. I'm Diana, and my last name is Logoli. I am fantastic. Despite we actually chatted about the weather here in Sweden, which is quite dark, but we are keeping up the light. So all good.
All good. Very good. Okay, so you are Diana is a leading success and business coach in Scandinavia, and a global influencer who helped more than 100 entrepreneurs from 23 countries to launch and scale their online business. She is not your usual coach, and she has a master's in business, but her expertise is a unique fusion of theory and practice as a serial entrepreneur for more than 16 years. So tell me a little bit more about mindset and digital strategies. What do they do, and how that can they help a small business?
So I have this insight that, you know, digital strategies, and there are a lot of stuff that are really teachable and Googleable in this day and age. We can learn pretty much everything.
Absolutely.
We have so many information on our fingertip. And these are basically the strategies that, you know, now so popular, everyone wants to have their online business, especially now when we are in the midst of pandemic. You know, people are going from maybe in-person business or brick and mortar to actually having an online business. So these strategies is not something that I would love to like really explain into the details, because that's available. What I would love to go in is more about how intentional we are about what are we doing? What is our purpose? And actually like doing something that you really, really enjoy. Because once, or 3 years ago, when I started my online business, I did it something that was available to me, but not necessarily something that I love doing. And here, like, actually that mindset kicks in, where a lot of people think, yo, I'm going to do this because that's like trendy. And that's what society like wants me to do. Or that's like something that I can learn quickly and implement and get, you know, rich quick, which is just an illusion, right? More of a being intentional and mindful about what it is that I actually want. You know, who am I? What do I have that can actually change the world? I know that this is so lofty, and you know, why should we even care about the world? But it's really like, if you have so many information on your fingertip, why not use them in a purposeful way to actually contribute? Because one of our basic needs is contribution and growth. And if you want to grow, might that be like really intentional and purposeful for someone else?
You need to be able to contribute something anyway. I mean, regardless of it's in your personal life or your business life, you know, the purpose of being is to contribute to the world and its well-being. And so, you know, what you're doing, I guess, is doing it in an intentional way, and doing intentional goal setting. And we'll talk about that in a moment. I think is a great way to go. And for a business owner, it would be the ideal time now to actually do that intentional goal setting, because, you know, you just never know when you're going to be shoved back into lockdown again. And, you know, you may have just gone out of having to do your business online. And now you went to in person, and now you've had to go back to online. So, you know, you need to, I guess, make up your mind whether you're going to be a hybrid business owner, or, you know, whether you're going to, and I hate this word, but, you know, pivot your business. So So, you know, what are your thoughts on that?
I think as long as it sits well with you, I think that a lot of people think that, you know, I'm going to do this hot thing. I'm going to make money and, you know, everything will be okay. Where we actually lose that fulfillment and, you know, having in mind that intention, not just what it is for me, but does this thing makes me happy? You know, because I believe and I experience that, and a lot of my clients experience that. When you do something that makes you happy, that has a byproduct is like making more money, because when you are happy, that's like you can bring more that joy and more passion into what you're doing. And that really feels like you, your clients, your people who are resonating with your message, they're going to feel. And I think a lot of people just underestimate the feeling of being happy, because that is a choice. And why not choose a business that is, or a model that makes you happy? So when it comes to pivoting, yes, of course, everyone can pivot. Just pivot for the sake that, you know, for sake of your own happiness, not for because of like that's trendy to do. Of course, we need to be flexible. Entrepreneurs, I think that what makes us entrepreneurs is that we are flexible and we have that grit and perseverance, but also being mindful that is this the thing that on the long run still will make me happy?
Yeah.
Having like, you know, those vision and mission in mind.
Yeah. So I guess getting back to intentional goal setting, how does one go about doing that? Mm-hmm.
So it's simple as it is it a question, what it is.
Yeah, I what want. Is it? Yeah, I guess, yeah. What is it?
Because a lot of people miss that and they do maybe what their partner want, maybe what their kids want, maybe what, you know, what they thought to be that is right, maybe what their parents want, you know. And we forget about that, what it is, like internally, what do I want? And it's a very, very simple question, but a lot of people like get stuck with, a lot of people actually ask me, I don't know what I want. How do you determine what I want? And here's the catch. If money wouldn't be an issue, or you would have like, you know, you will be like really, really resourceful when it comes to money, what would you be doing? Simple as that. Would you still be doing what you're doing right now?
I know I would be, but yeah. But right? Yeah.
And it's that, you know, intention is, what is your intention behind everything that you're doing? And I love to ask myself every morning the question, who do I need to be today? That's the intention, how I'm going to show up. How I'm going to have a conversation with you, Rose, how I'm going to have a conversation with my team, how I'm going to have a conversation with my clients. Who do I need to be today? And being like, really, okay, do I need to be a fun mom today? Do I need to be, you know, whatever that is. And having that in mind really puts you into perspective.
Yeah.
Okay. Without like, you know, because a lot of people are reacting instead of being proactive.
Yeah. So using that model, how do they then actually set a goal for themselves or and their business?
One of the key things that I think that the smart goal setting is missing is the ingredients of the feeling, because we are emotional human beings, right? Last time I checked, we are still surrounded with robots. We are driven by emotions. That's how it is. And if we don't put emotions behind our goals, this is where we miss. Like, it's okay. They are specific. They're attainable. They are like, you know, whatever smart goals mean, you know, in a theory. Where the intentional goal setting is different is because of the why. And going as deep as, like, why is this important to me? Why do I need to achieve this? You know, asking yourself why, in terms of getting so deep that you'll know that once, I don't know if I can curse, but once it really gets hard,
yeah,
once shit hits the fan, you know, you need to be able to get yourself back there into the game. That's your why. And having this intention that it's why is this important to you to achieve? I don't like to, you know, the word hustle, but more of a, you know, this is important on the long run. And when we are growing, when we are reaching that next level, we will always hit an obstacle. That doesn't mean that that goal is not available or it's not meant to be achieved. It's just like the universe, the God, whoever you believe in, is there to test you. It's like in a games, you know, you need to kill the dragon or whoever, to get to that next level. It's same here, you know, do you have the grit to actually to get to that next level? And when you have intention and you know your why, you have that feeling behind your goal, it's easier. Because then when you remember, why is it in the first place that you want to go towards that goal, it's easy, you know, just being mindful and remembering, okay, yeah, this is why I signed up for this.
Yeah, sometimes I think business, Mrs. Owners, even entrepreneurs, or just anyone really, sometimes forget their why about, you know, why they've actually wanting to do a particular thing, you know, whether it's a sportsman who, you know, wants to achieve, you know, the best in his area, or an entrepreneur who's got, you know, whatever level of expertise and, you know, they want to, you know, upskill and become, you know, top of their game. So it makes a lot of sense to know, you know, what the why is. But what if you don't know what your why is? What if you sort of think, well, yeah, this is what I know this is what I want to do, but I don't know why I really want to do it. How mm-hmm. does one find that? Or how does one drill down into, you know, describing or, you know, finding that purpose, I guess?
So I'm going to give you an example from one of my stories that I experienced when I started my last business, because I run several businesses, and it was, I want to have more freedom. Online business will eventually give me that freedom that I can work whenever I want and I can spend more time with my kids, right? That was my why. So I can be available. I have 3 kids and I was always, you know, I can be available when they are, you know, there is a school dance or whatever that is. I can be that mom who will, you know, have this and this. Where I actually realized that soon when I was starting my business, I spent more time sacrificing my kids and their time, really grinding in my business. And then at one point I got burned out. My husband said, you know, this is not working. And, you know, you need to set your priorities. You know, this is not working. It's always like, let me just finish this, or let me just do this. And then I'm going to first this and then family. And it wasn't about me prioritizing myself. It was me prioritizing business. I'm not saying that you shouldn't be as a mom, as a woman, you should be always taking care of yourself first, you know, putting that oxygen mask first on yourself and then the kids and everything. But this was me prioritizing business, not myself, because I was also jeopardizing my health because I was working 15, 16 hours. And once I got to a place where I was really ill, my father got a heart attack. He's also an entrepreneur, and I also had an abortion. That was where I just needed to look deep. What am I trying to achieve? Why did I sign up for this? And it was because of the freedom, because I wanted to spend more time with kids, and yet I was jeopardizing that thing. And once it dawned on me, and I said, like, wait a second, It's not like when I'm going to have this successful business, then I'm going to spend time with my kids. It's other way around. Because kids and time, this is something that, you know, you can't stop their growth. And now you can't stop. Now is the time to spend time with my kids. And, you know, because that makes me happy. And once I realize that, you know, I'm going to put their priorities and their time into my schedule first. Of course, myself and then them. And then business comes. I realize that I need to find a way that I'm going to work smarter and not kill myself. Mm. And things that make me happy, like coaching, speaking, those are the things that I can do. And the rest of the things that I was doing in my business, it's easy to outsource or to delegate. So I just needed to straighten up my priorities, what it is that I'm doing in my business and what can someone else do at home, in business, and going back to that why, when I remembered, like, this is because of my kids. I want to be available for them. And again, like every, like you mentioned, like every sportsman, like in sports or famous people or people who really made successful businesses, it's backed up by their story, some experience that they had and got to a place, oh no, this hurts me, I don't want to go back there. So I love to say, like, your why is, instead of like why is a question, what hurts you?
Mm-hmm.
What hurts me is the fact that I can't spend the time with my kids.
Yeah.
And that's my why.
And that's a really great story. And that's a really good explanation of, you know, how to, do you define what your why really is? And the oxygen mask and all of those things is absolutely correct. You know, you need to know what your true why is, not just, you know, I want to make more money, or I want to have more freedom, or I want to do this, or I want to do that. It's not really a why until you can get right down into your heart center and, you know, really have an honest discussion with yourself about what it is that you, or why you are in business in the first place.
Your why is always very individual and very specific to you. Because everyone wants money. Who doesn't want money? Of course. But that's like general.
Yeah.
And if we say like, yes, I want to have financial freedom, but why? Why is this financial freedom so important to you? And you will say, because I don't want to go back to my job. Okay. So why don't you, like, why is this important to you? Why do you don't want to go back to? Because I don't want to have someone who will determine when I get up, or, you know, and when you peel off all these, like, you know, levels, you come down to that. One of my mentors, Dean Graziosi, that's actually his explanation of why we go like 7 levels deep. So ask yourself 7 times, why? Every time you hit an answer, ask yourself, so why is this important? Okay, so then go to the next level. And once you come after the 5th why, you will see that this is really like emotional thing. You will feel,
yeah, and a lot of people don't want to go down that deep because they're too frightened to discover or to find out what they might discover about themselves. It might be that, you know, they're not really doing it for the right reasons.
100%. If you, and then, you know, why entrepreneurs actually stop or quit is because they didn't go deep enough.
Yeah.
And this is where we talk about mindset. It's not, mindset is not something that you read, you know.
Oh, absolutely not. No.
Think and grow rich, like create a book and, you know, it's not like that. It's really, really going deep with yourself and really identifying what it is that I want and why am I doing.
Yeah,
a lot of people, that's a hard work. It's simple, but it's also like, you know, it's simple, but it's not easy. It is like, you know, a work.
It's very emotional. It's very emotional work to drill down. I mean, I've got a friend of mine who's a mindset, and she delivers on mind shift, like her specialty is mind shift. And I've got another friend who is a master NLP coach, and you know, and I've actually done her timeline therapy, and that was really eye-opening for me, you know, to shift, you know, some personal rubbish that I had going on, and shift the way I thought about my business as well, you know. So, yeah, mindset's not something that you, that it's just there. It's a really deep emotional onion that you need to peel the layers off.
Onion. Yeah, you need to peel, and it's all about perspective, because more, you know, if you think of how we are brought up, is with different stories. Stories of our parents, stories of our grandparents, stories of our teachers, you know, all these people are telling you something and you can't filter, is that true or not?
Yeah.
And more of these stories like determine who you are. And when you get into your adulthood and you're questioning, is this true or not? You just bought into a story, someone else's story. It's not yours. It's not, you know, universal truth. And you can change. And that's what, where the shift happens. Just questioning, is that true for me? You know, and you can actually, you can, even if you believe that that's true for you, you're having the belief that common belief is, you know, you need to work hard in order to be successful. That is just a belief. I am an immigrant daughter, and my parents, they hustled. They really worked hard their entire life or professional career. My father, that's why he got heart attack. My mom, she was a nurse, and she was literally working 42 years for the same company. And she was, you know, working really hard. And that's how I was brought up. You need to work 14, 16 hours, you know. That was the story that I bought into.
Yeah.
Until I met that rock bottom and I needed to question, well, that can be true. Because there are people who are successful and they are not working 16 hours. It has to be a different story there available to me as well. It's just like how you, you know, make a shift and decide. It is a decision.
Yep.
Decide that this story will not be true for you.
Yeah. And choices, you know, choice is a big thing, I guess. You know, I think choice, you can choose to be happy, you can choose to be sad. It's your choice. You know, no one can make you do it. And you're right about beliefs. You know, you can either believe something to be true or you can question that belief and you know, make up your own belief about something, you know, whether the sky is blue or whether it's green or it's purple or whatever.
And here's a good part. I would love for your listeners and your viewers to question everything that we are saying right here.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Because it's just my perspective and Rose's perspective. So question. It doesn't need to be like, okay, yeah, you're right. Ask yourself, is this right and true for me?
Yeah, absolutely. Yep, I agree. You know, I say in some of the blurb of this podcast that, you know, that's just one person's perspective. It's not gospel, you know. It's the people who I speak with, you know, it's just how they believe their business or what they're teaching. It's how they believe it to be the truth. So, you know, I want people to question what they're listening to, because, you know, that promotes conversation, and conversations are good.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. All right. So we've run out of time, Deanna, I'm sorry, but have you got any words of wisdom that you'd like to impart?
I would love to say, one of the things that I really, really love about, you know, business and just in general life is to really be mindful of who you are. When you know yourself, and I think that's the ultimate freedom, to knowing yourself and being in your truth, your own truth. And whenever you have an opportunity to speak your truth, to share your voice, to share your message, take that and be fearless about that. because your truth matters. You matter. Your voice matters, whatever that is.
Absolutely, Brewer. You know, I've been getting some card readings lately, and you know, that's just exactly what they've been saying. So, you know, what you've just said is, yeah, it's obviously I need to hear that again and again and again, and to, you know, to walk in my own truth and, you know, believe in my, that I do have a voice. And yeah, we all have a voice and we should be heard. Yeah, I agree. Anyway, thank you so much for today. I've really enjoyed the conversation, and perhaps we'll get you on another time and you could share
thank you so
a little
much.
Bit I really more. Enjoyed. All right. Thank you.